Hi everyone, my name is Stephen Simon and right now you're watching the first episode of C-Sharp Corner MVP show. And in today's episode, we have Mr. Vivek Sharma, who's a C-Sharp Corner MVP and one of the youngest contributors in the community. You can often find him talking about games, development, 2D, 3D and a lot more in Delhi NCR and even in Pan India. So hi Vivek, welcome to the show. How are you feeling today?
Hello Stephen, I'm feeling great. Thanks a lot for inviting me.
So what were you doing? Did we really disturb you to take this interview?
No, not at all.
I think it really took us long to set up this audio call, right?
Yes.
Anyway. So Vivek, you have been doing a lot of work in the field of game development. And at the same time, also, I know that you do a lot of company stuff and all. So will you just tell what you do in your day-to-day job and what actually got you started your own company?
Currently, I'm running a game development company called Kingster 66 Games. And I started this in the college time.
Okay.
And the only motivation behind this was the passion I have for innovating and creating new things.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, this all started with the Imagine Cup in which we both were together.
Yeah, so, I remember that part. That was it. I think many people may not know that I and Vivek come from the same college, right? but we don't tell our college name, right? That's going to be a secret. We don't tell our college name. But indeed, we both started talking when we went into Imagine Cup. I think that is a contest every student must participate. One of the world's largest student developer contest. Why don't you talk about what are the projects that you built in that Imagine Cup and how did it go?
Okay, so we actually started in 2015 when, earlier there were some more contests like pitch contest and all that. So we started with the pitch contest and we were creating an app for deaf, blind and people who cannot speak.
Okay.
And we got honorable mention on Imagine Cup for that.
Mm-hmm.
And our main project was a safety suit for bike riders. Unfortunately,
yeah.
We didn't win, but we made it to national finals.
Yeah,
together.
Yeah, I know. Even I was there. So I saw your project. It was really nice when you were really struggling behind the doors. I saw that. It's been a long journey, I think, coming from that 2015 Imagine Cup and then starting your own company. I think you have done a very long journey. In the meanwhile, you came into C-Sharp Corner. I think then you met Mahesh Chand, who really helped you in your project initially. Let us talk about how a student who got funded from a CEO of a company and then eventually went on to become his own CEO.
It all started with Nitin Pandit sir, who was our mentor at that time. He introduced us to the C-Sharp Corner conference. He introduced us to Mahesh Chand sir.
Yeah.
And there it all started.
Okay. So I think your first session at, do you remember your first, you do a lot of speaking, right? I see. We both are more like, we're not good at writing. We don't write much article, but we are someone who are always available and actually go and speak in local events. What was the first event where you spoke at C-Sharp Corner?
If you remember, we both went for the same session on the exact same day at Sundar Deep Institute in Ghaziabad or some place.
Yeah, exactly. And I think
that was our first session on IoT.
We really struggled to get at least one t-shirt of C-Sharp Corner. Yeah, we really troubled the team. At least we need one t-shirt. And I think now we have been attending C-Sharp Corner Annual Developer Conference. You have been an active speaker from a really long time. So, and we have a bunch of goodies with us. Okay. So in the past, when you started working with the Unity, what is something that really interests you to work on Unity? I mean, there are many other game engines too. I think if I remember, there's Unreal in the same time, and I started with Construct 2. So why did you choose Unity and what's the benefit for that?
Okay, the number one reason was again Microsoft Imagine Cup.
Okay, is
because,
it?
Because, at that time, there was also a category for Unity games in the Imagine Cup.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wanted to participate in that. So that's the reason why I started Unity. But after that, I learned a lot about it and got to know that there are features which are not actually available in Construct and Unreal.
Okay.
So that's how I ended up being a Unity developer full time.
Okay, so being in C-Sharp Corner MVP, when you go and speak in the local events, what do you actually cover in those topics? Is it just Unity, or there's a project that you try to deliver to the students or the developers? What is the main criteria that if you go and speak tomorrow, well, what do you actually cover in that?
See, it actually depends. If I'm in front of absolute beginner students, okay, then I try to create a new Unity project, mm-hmm, a new short game, yeah, and bring it to the end. Okay. So that at the end of the day, each and every student attending my session knows how Unity works, how to create a small game, and mm-hmm, they probably becomes able to create a short game after that session. So that's my whole motto.
I remember even that time I made a Unity game, right? Although if people are hearing, I'm really not at all good. I forgot the Unity, how it's being done. So Unity is a good platform. I think people should be using it. So the company that you're running, let us talk about now. This company, you're situated in the capital of India, that is Delhi, and now you run a gaming company. Let us talk about what is the team, what projects you're developing, and let's just talk about it.
Okay, we have a short team with people which emphasize really on their core technologies.
Yeah.
We have guys who takes care of the back end. We have guys who takes care of the designing part, mm-hmm, guys who takes care of the web development part, and some more Unity developers who concentrates corely on the Unity front end.
Mm-hmm.
And we have not just been working on Unity in this company. We have been doing a lot of other stuff. We have been creating a AR social network, which is called Big Being. We have been creating a women safety device to prevent them from sexual assault and all that, mm-hmm, called EP, and a lot of that kind of stuff as well.
Mm-hmm.
That's the whole journey.
So I think, having said that, you also have a video course on C-Sharp that is for the Unity, right? So if you could just take away, yeah, what are the things that you cover in that video series, and how is that helpful to the beginners?
Okay, if there is a person who don't absolutely knows anything about Unity, mm-hmm, he wants to learn Unity and wants to be at a level from where he can start creating his own games,
mm-hmm,
then that series is for that particular person. Mm-hmm. That's a very small series. It's just gonna take a user's 1 hour or two.
Okay.
And after going through that series, he will be probably able to create his own game. So it's all about that.
That's really amazing. I mean, I think people should go, even the kids who want to move into this field of game. Well, one thing, Vivek, I coming from South Pacific Asia country, this is very true, and this may be even challenging for you, is to move into gaming, right? There are not many career numbers when I compare it to other development part. Also, there are not many game development company who have succeeded beautifully in the past. So how much tough it is to run a gaming company and at the same time look for the talented guys who are working into this field?
It's absolutely very, very difficult to survive in the gaming industry, first of all. Second thing, there are very less Unity developers in India. Mm-hmm. The number is extremely too short. Mm-hmm. So it's extremely difficult to find a particular perfect guy who will be able to match our requirements.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a task. But it's a great journey because, you are always doing designing part, animation part, and that's where the whole thrill is hidden. So that is something which excites me and keeps me going with this.
So that's really it. I mean, I think gaming is something where you both code and you play with the colors and all at the same time. Okay. So I remember when I was working at the Unity almost like 3 to 4 years back, then we had different programming languages, different options, like 3 to 4 options to mm-hmm. actually go and start coding. A lot has changed, I think, right now. So would you like to talk about how Unity has changed, evolved, and how to get started with it?
See, earlier they used to support, I guess, Go, JavaScript, and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But currently they are just focusing on C-Sharp because of its object-oriented nature.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, Unity have evolved a lot.
Mm-hmm.
It, I guess, currently supports more than 24 platforms, I believe, including Android, iOS, Mac, PlayStation, and all that, mm-hmm. Xbox. So that is something which excites people to go to Unity. And other than that, earlier, Unreal Engine was a tough competitor, okay, because it had great graphics.
Okay.
But Unity was lagging in that. After that, Unity decided to create something for its shader part,
mm-hmm.
as as create something called post-processing.
Okay.
So after watching the post-processing, the Unity is even better than Unreal Engine in the terms of graphics.
Mm-hmm.
And it's free for the users.
Mm-hmm.
So anybody can just start creating a Unity game. As well as other engines have a problem that, see, Unreal Engine charges 4% of your business if you succeed.
That's a lot
for a startup.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
That's why Unity is good, and I love that.
And I think Microsoft has been promoting Unity a lot. They have been a very good partners both in the past. As you talked about, you were in the Imagine Cup, and Unity was one of the reason. I remember we really had good time at the Imagine Cup part, and it's very good contest. That is where we both started our journey. Now let's actually talk about the programming skills that is required to move into this gaming development. Okay, so I mean, if I am a developer, say let us take two scenarios. First, I'm a student studying in a college, undergraduate, and second, I'm a developer. Okay, so in these two case scenarios, what are the skills I need to move into the field of game development?
See, it all depends. If you want to go into the coding side of the Unity or just the designing part, see, it's not just about games, right?
Okay.
It's about AR, it's about VR, it's about architectural stuff, it's about interiors, it's about, you know, automotive industry as well. So it all actually depends. If you are a designer, you can start creating 3D models and cool animations. If you just want to go into the coding part, that's absolutely amazing. If you also want to stay away from all this and you are a musician, then also Unity is great for you. So
is it?
Yeah. Because the sounds and music is extremely expensive, right?
I remember, I think there's something called physics in the Unity, right? Which actually talks about light, weight, mass and all. I think a very long time I've worked. So, see, it is like if you're a student, entirely, maybe you're a student, maybe you're a developer, entirely depends upon you. You may come from a coding background or may not. There are many things. I think, having said that, I think when you run a company of entire game development, you're not just reliable on just one Unity, right? Just one single ID. What are the different softwares and third-party applications you also expect any employee working in your company or a game development work other than the game engine itself?
See, there are definitely designing softwares, including Photoshop, and there are 3D modeling and animation softwares as well. We generally goes with Blender. We prefer that because that's easy to start with.
Okay.
But see, I've seen other people using Maya and Max.
Mm-hmm.
We have currently started working with Substance Painter as well to create extremely smooth 3D models.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. We are using Visual Studio for coding and Unity for the rest of the stuff.
So you use Microsoft Visual Studio?
Yeah.
Or is it, so now, in my case, I do not have a Visual Studio installed because when I work on Python or maybe I work on PHP, I prefer to use Visual Studio Code because that is very lightweight. So is it possible that if I have Visual Studio Code installed, I can then code for Unity not having Studio?
Yes, exactly. I have Visual Studio Code installed on my PC and I'm currently using that only.
So it's totally fine if I don't have a Studio. That's a very big version. Okay.
All it's the, absolutely fine. You can even start coding on Notepad for Unity.
Okay, that is it? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It's just the intelligence and management of the library that helps you out. That's good. That's perfect. So I think one thing that should be focused is that although we are members from a C# Corner community that says C#, but it's a community that encourages developers from an entire ecosystem to come and contribute here and learn for at the same time. I think if you will go to the technology section, you can find Unity, C#, Angular, .NET, everything over there, right?
Yeah.
So how do you see or promote young guys or encourage the young people or people who are into developing field? What one thing you should tell them that should help them to move into the game development field?
See, to move into the game development field, the most important thing is imagination.
Okay.
Nothing else is required.
I really don't have one, that's for sure. I'm bad at colors.
Yeah. But
you accept that?
No, I'm not saying that. I was continuing one sentence. Okay. So if you want to do it professionally, then you should definitely be aware of the coding standards, the naming conventions used in C#, because that actually matters if you are going for the enterprise level game development.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the only thing what actually matters, and everything you can learn, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So everything. Yeah.
Vivek, as you run your own company, do you also do hiring in your company? How does that hiring happens? What are the skills that you actually check? Let us move to the, okay, if I'm a student and I have learned Unity now, if you come and start interviewing me, what are the skills that you're going to check me and what will be the actual process that I'll have to go through?
See, it depends if I'm hiring a fresher or I'm looking for experienced guy. Okay. If I'm looking for a fresher, it doesn't even matter if you know how to use Unity, have you ever worked on Unity or not.
Mm-hmm.
If because all what we see is the kind of person and the willingness to learn.
Mm-hmm.
When we are looking for an experienced developer, say 5 to 6 years of experience, then the whole game changes. Then we completely focuses on the technical part of the Unity development.
Okay.
So this is how it's judged.
I mean, just basically, I mean, if you're a beginner, you just need to know, have basic skills on how to work around the IDE. That is something initially
no, guys should believe. No. If you are a fresher, we don't even expect that you have ever opened up Unity. And that's absolutely fine with us because, there is always a start. So we get a new guy, we teaches him or her how they can start, and within I guess next 1 to 2 days they are all set to create.
that's great. But in that case, I think I can join you anytime, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely sure.
Okay, you don't live far; we lived very nearby. I hope everyone is safe this time. This COVID-19, this virus, everyone stays safe. And anyway. So, on moving to the end note, let's talk about the annual conference that we actually go and speak. We couldn't have this year C-Sharpcon annual conference because for the same virus, and we hope everyone stay safe, stay close to your family, prepare, have the sanitation. So how do you actually prepare for this conference part when you go and speak? Okay, so let's talk about the conferences. You have been speaking in many different conferences, some of the official conferences of Unity also. What do you, as a CEO of the company, or when you go and meet many seniors guys from the other industry, what do you actually go and learn and how this things goes?
When you meet other people who are good in their areas, definitely you get to learn a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, I was not very, aware and focusing on something of which is the optimization of the game.
Mm-hmm.
But after attending all these sessions, all these conferences, I learned one thing which is absolutely new to me every time.
Okay.
So this is how they helps me. And if it's about my session in a conference, mm-hmm. then there is a lot of work which goes behind that.
Yeah.
Because we have to take care of all of the audience segments.
Yeah.
We have audience with a guy who is 18 years old, and we have an experienced guy who is like 50.
Exactly.
So we have to put up a content which is suitable for both, and everybody can understand and get some value out of that. So that is the most important.
I remember last time you did an AR part, right? I think you did an AR and VR talk last year conference, right? That is something really, I think not many people in the Delhi and NCR do the game development. Now, especially talking about the AR, you're one among very few. And if you people watching this, I'll leave Vivek C-Sharpcon a link in the description. You can just go through that link profile and you'll find his social media links. You can connect with him if you want to get into this field of the game development. So while we wrap this video, one thing that you would like to suggest to all the viewers about the game development or the struggles that you faced while moving into this game field. Let's talk about it and wrap this MVP show.
See, the struggles are, there are struggles in everything. See,
yeah.
If you are going into game development or if you are talking about general in life,
yeah,
struggles are everywhere. It's just that you have to keep on working.
Mm-hmm.
If you face a problem, that's absolutely fine. You don't have to stop.
Okay.
You just keep on going and one day you will arrive. That's
great. I mean, the text at the background, small team doing big things, that says a lot that what you have been doing and with your company. Thank you so much, Vivek. Thank you so much for your time. You have been really helpful to us, both for the community and especially for this video part. It took us a long to the audio setup. Thank you so much for your time. And thank you everyone who's watching this video call. And we hope to see you in the next MVP show. Thank you so much. Time. Bye. Take care.
Thank you. Goodbye.